read in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 26 and again chapter 28, King Saul comes to kill David and he enters into the cave to release himself. And then when he goes to release himself, he has to be alone. He carries water. He entered into the cave and afterwards he did not know how to come out of it. And in that cave, David is there. When you remain faithful to God, God will bring your enemies to your feet. You need not worry. You remain faithful to God. Yes. And when David was told by his friend, look, Saul has come to kill you and God has put him into your hand. You need not to kill. Give me permission. I need not to strike him second time. With one striking, he will be no more. David said, no. Don't touch the one who is anointed by God. The enemy will come. When you are in trouble, when you are in disturbance, the enemy will give you a shortcut. No shortcut. The cross is our power. Many shortcuts Satan will tell you. How to earn money. How to become friendly with somebody. All the tricks the world will teach you. How you can attract a man. How you can attract a woman. How you can become famous. How you can become influential. Many shortcuts of the world. The psychological methods, they are just thrown in the internet. And many people are running after it. No. No. The cross will teach you that your life is much more precious. Your life is a gift God has sent to you. Your life may become a cross to lay down your life. David, he never touched the anointed one. He kept the Lord and he suffered. Saul went out and again started to running after David to kill him. The man who were filled with the evil spirit, he died with his own sword. David, in his time, was raised up by God and he became the king and the ancestor of the Lord Jesus Christ. If your suffering is so much, your blessing also will be that great. If God wants you to go through deep valleys, there will be deep anointing. God will never take you where the grace of God will not protect you. God will never take you where the grace of God will not provide you. Close your eyes for a minute. At times God may lead you to various kind of. Your life may look like a cross. No, God will turn. The cross is the symbol of turning the curses into blessing. Cross means it is an instrument that transforms. Galatians chapter 3 verse 10 to 14, that Christ has become curse for us, that the curses of this world will be removed by our life that we offer on the cross, and we become source of help. Two sisters, they came, and the younger sister whose husband became an abnormal man with abnormal way of living, and he left him here and he married after he went away. And then they are Hindus. They came to the Lord. The whole families received baptism. They are now in the Lord. And then suddenly she was asking me, Father, we came for you. You are not there. I said, you should wait for the Lord, not for me. I was talking. Then the younger girl said, my life has become a curse, Father. In the young age, I lost my husband. What is the meaning of my life? I was just praying. The Holy Spirit came and told her. Her name is Prasanna. Prasanna, why do you say you are a curse? Maybe your husband left you, but today you are the blessing for your family. Are you not the only one who takes care of the mother? Are you not the only one? Through you, the whole family is kept alive. Are you not the only one who goes everywhere to strengthen the people? Because of you, so many families are living. Is it not true? She said, yes, Father. Just a fraction of a second, when the Holy Spirit comes, He reveals the truth. Man by nature tends to see only the suffering. They can't go beyond the suffering because the enemy binds us with the suffering and we feel so miserable about our suffering. We feel so miserable about ourselves. That's what Satan does. But when we go to the Holy Spirit, He will teach us. If God allows certain kind of suffering in our lives, through which how many blessings God is leading us, giving through us. Yes. When I said, and her sister Padma and her sister Prasanna both knelt down and praised to God, thank you, Lord, for making us blessing to the world, blessing to our families. And suddenly the elder girl said, Father, because of me, so many people in the factory, she's having a manager rank, because of me, so many people are praying. They're asking me, Madam, you are traveling so many kilometers and come. Your face is always shining. You are always fresh. What is the secret? That gives me an opportunity to speak about Jesus. And today, in my factory, if I don't come, they feel upset. And during the break time, earlier they used to speak ill of others. Now they all pray. Your suffering, if you move, look at the cross, it will become source of life. You will turn the curses into blessing. Yes. Hallelujah.